We would like to... Oh, you got me? All right, we're good. We would like to acknowledge that today's concert is happening on the ancestral lands of the Abenaki. We recognize and honor them now, their ancestors in the past, and their children in the future. Welcome. My name is Melissa Richmond, and I am wearing both of my hats for you today. I am the music director at Saint-Gaudens Memorial and also the executive director at the West Claremont Center for Music and the Arts. Thank you all for being here with us today for this final concert of the season. We are very glad to welcome you for the 16th annual Rosamond Edmondson Memorial Concert, and it's presented by both Saint-Gaudens and the West Claremont Center, and today we are here at Union Episcopal Church in Claremont. We would like to thank Phil and Hillary Burling for their continued sponsorship of this concert. We would also like to recognize that this concert is supported in part by a grant from the New Hampshire State Council on the Arts and the National Endowment for the Arts, and by the New England State's touring program of the New England Foundation for the Arts, made possible with funding from the National Endowment for the Arts Regional Touring Program and the six New England State Arts Agencies. So there's a lot of people who are really appreciative of what we're doing here today. Thank you to everyone who has already made a donation to this season or to this concert. We're very appreciative. It really helps to support both of these two wonderful organizations. And I would like to let you know also that after today's concert that you're all invited, whether you're online and are able to come over or outside, that we will be having a meet and greet with the artists and a tour of the yet-to-be-renovated Claremont Creative Center, which is at 56 Opera House Square in Claremont. And we have a very exciting announcement to make regarding that today. We have received a pledge from the Jack and Dorothy Byrne Foundation for a $100,000 matching grant. So all of the funds that we raise towards the capital project until we reach $200,000 will be matched 50%. We're so appreciative of the Byrne Foundation for that vote of confidence for this project. So like I said, this is our last concert of the season, but we will have some programs coming up in the fall. And if you'd like to be kept in the loop, please sign up for the mailing list. Katie will be happy to help you get set up. She's over right by the table where you came in, if you're here in person, or if you're online, you can do that right from our webpage. If you need a copy of today's program, you can go right to the West Claremont Center's webpage, wcc-ma.org, and the concert program will be right there on the front page. We are so, so pleased to be able to finally welcome the Apple Hill String Quartet to our program. Normally, they are very busy during the end of the summer and are not able to join us during the season. So we're grateful to have you all with us today and to have our good friend Sally Pinkas join as well later in the program. So that is all for me. I'm sure you're ready to hear some music. Please join me in welcoming the Apple Hill String Quartet.
Good afternoon. Our first piece is a piece by William Grant Still, one of America's beloved African-American composers. He is one of the founding members of the Harlem Renaissance, probably the first to actually have an opera premiered by the New York Opera, as well as the first to conduct a major orchestra. So he's quite a figure in the music community. We have here a movement from the Lyric Quartet. This quartet was written as sort of impressions of three of his friends. The first one is the Sentimental one, the second one is the Quiet one, and the third one is the Jovial one. We're going to play for you today the Sentimental one.
Thank you. So this next piece that we're going to play is a piece called Pannonia, Boundless, and the composer is Aleksandra Vrebalov. In a word, it is basically just a whole bunch of gypsy dances combined into one. And what she did to research this piece and different types of phrasings and styles is that she went to Europe, to southern, southeastern Europe, and went into bars, haunts, sort of communities, and just recorded and listened to the traditional styles of playing gypsy music. And so this is sort of what she came up with. It is a pot of wonderful gypsy soup. And it is quite wonderful, and I think it's also quite wonderful that for those out in the audience outside, each member of the quartet will get a little bit of a solo. And so it's a wonderful audio experience to listen to sort of who has the solo, who has the melody, and I feel like it will be progressively harder as the song gets, as the piece goes on, who has the melody, who has the primary voice. But this was commissioned by the Kronos Quartet, a very wonderful quartet who stylizes all different styles of music. This is Pannonia, Boundless.
Thank you. to César Franck's magnificent piano quintet in F minor. It was written between 1878 and 79, and in fact it predates by a few years his most famous piece, the violin and piano sonata. And it's equally passionate and equally huge, especially for my instrument. I was reading that apparently Franck had huge hands, which explained a lot of the span for an organist. It's extremely passionate. In fact, it is suspected that he wrote it while he was in love with one of his students, and consequently his wife hated it, apparently. A little tidbit. Another little tidbit, it was dedicated to Camille Saint-Saëns, who was his great friend, and Camille Saint-Saëns also was the pianist who premiered it, but apparently did not like it because he thought it was modulating too much, so he kind of stalked out at the end of the performance and left the manuscript, which was gifted to him, on the piano, and I think Franck was a little bit hurt by that. In any event, at this point, this quintet is one of the four most important piano quintets among the Schumann, Brahms, and Dvořák, I would say. And I think it has a very unique way of combining our instruments, rather than putting us in opposition or kind of competing, it sort of joins us, which is a wonderful, wonderful thing. I hope you like it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.